Hi everyone, welcome back to Nathuan's Diaries. Today we are here with a vlog. So this video was taken on a Christmas day and there are some few preparations from the Christmas Eve too. So keep watching. We started our day with a morning prayer to welcome baby Jesus to our hearts. Then comes the most exciting part of Christmas Day, opening the gifts. My son was really excited to open them and see what is inside. We don't usually buy a lot of things during Christmas because we usually buy things that we needed throughout the year. Our Christmas gifts include some toys, chocolate, and a few books for Aaron, a book for me, and an egg boiler, which was a gift from our friend. One of his gifts was a Treasure X toy, which was gifted by my brother and sister-in-law, and Aaron really likes it. My son really likes to read inspirational life stories, so I bought him a set of books in that category. My book was a gift from my husband, A Promised Land, a book by our former US President Mr. Barack Obama, which was officially released in November 2020. Now I will show you some Christmas preparations that I made on the Christmas Eve so that our Christmas day will be a little less hectic. I have peeled and washed some onions, ginger, garlic and some shallots. Fermented appam batter is ready to keep in the fridge so that tomorrow morning we can make breakfast with it. I am preparing Kerala plum cake and fish curry today and I have washed and sliced the beef pieces so that I can cook it. The tamarind water for the fish curry is ready. I have cut the duck into medium pieces and I am dividing them in two Ziploc bags so that one I can use it for later and one for tomorrow. I usually vacuum seal the Ziploc bags before putting it in the freezer by submerging it in a pot of water so that the meat will be staying fresh and we can save some space in the freezer. If you haven't tried this method of vacuum sealing at home, it is very simple to do and it keeps your meat stays fresher for a longer period of time. So the one bag is ready to go to the refrigerator and the other bag is ready to go to the freezer. I will be pressure cooking the beef along with the raw plantain pieces by adding some masala powders. Now I am making a fish curry, which is called red fish curry in Kerala. I am using the fish tuna here and it is very simple and it is very tasty. I haven't included any recipes in this vlog. If you want any recipes in particular, please comment us below so that we will try to add in the next vlog. We will wait until the fish and the meat gets cooked. Now our fish curry is ready. I'm transferring that fish curry into an earthen pot so that it will have more flavors on the next day. The beef and the plantains are also cooked very well. Now I will show you the process of soaking the dry fruits in the rum for making Christmas plum cake. I am making this kind of Christmas plum cake for the first time, so I have adapted this recipe from Dr. Lakshmi Nair vlogs. Here I have used some varieties of raisins, black currants, dried cherries, dried figs, some tutti frutti, and candied ginger. To the mix I am adding some orange marmalade, some peach preserve, and some honey and mixing it very well. To the mix I am adding a powdered mix of cloves, cardamom, cinnamon and nutmeg. After mixing very well, we will be adding the last ingredient but the hero of the dish, the rum. I will be adding 1 cup of rum. You can either add rum or brandy. The earlier you soak the dry fruits in the rum, the better the taste of your plum cake. And we can use this mixture for about 1 year. Now we will be making the most delicious Kerala Christmas plum cake. Since we are adding lot of dry fruits and nuts to this cake will take more time to cook when compared to other cakes. It took around 1 hour and 10 minutes for me to cook this cake. Finished with cooking part of the Christmas Eve, so and now I am starting to clean our home by wiping down the furnitures and mopping the floor. Now a clean home is ready to welcome baby Jesus. The last thing of the night, keeping some cookies and milk for Santa Claus. Morning started with making chicken stew and appam for the breakfast. Here I am making a very tasty but very easy chicken stew. Cooking only using the coconut milk and very less spices gives a unique taste to this dish. It had been raining for the past 2 days here, but it looks like a pleasant weather for today. Now the chicken stew is ready, we will start preparing appam with the fermented appam batter. It is around 8:20 here, we will be starting to eat the breakfast and we will be calling our parents in India. After the breakfast, I served my husband a piece of plum cake and homemade grape wine. It was a very delicious plum cake. It reminded us about the plum cake that we used to eat during our childhood in Kerala. After some chatting with the families and relatives, I have started preparing for lunch around 9:30. First, I am roasting some coconut for our beef plantain curry. I am using 2 burners here for making curries in order for us to save some time and have some time with the family. I'll be making duck roast in the bigger pot and will be making the beef and raw plantain curry in the other one. The beef and plantain in roasted coconut gravy, which is a very unique and tasty dish, which is usually served in Christian marriages in Kerala. First, we will be saute the onions, ginger, garlic and green chilies, and after it gets well done, we will be adding the cooked beef and the plantains. When the gravy gets boiled, we will be adding the grinded roasted coconut paste. We'll be simmering the curry until the oil floats on the top. For making the duck roast, I am using the duck with the skin on. Previously, I have made duck roast without the skin and the curry wasn't tastier like the ones we used to make with the skin on. Beef curry is almost ready. We'll be adding some fresh curry leaves in order to add some more flavor. Along with the non-veg dishes, I'm also making a seasoned buttermilk curry, which is also called as Moru Kachedu in Kerala. There are a lot of variations for this curry in Kerala, but today I'm making a very simple one without adding any vegetables. I felt very happy to see a pleasant day with lots of sunshine. Lastly, adding some coconut milk to the duck roast to elevate the taste. Lunch preparations are almost over. I have cleaned the dishes and cleaned the kitchen as well after everything. Lastly, cleaning my biggest helper in the kitchen, the mixer grinder. So the lunch is served along with the plum cake and the grape wine. Last time during Christmas, my parents were visiting here. This time, we missed our families very much. After the lunch, we started watching a Christmas movie called Christmas Chronicles. I really love to watch the Christmas movies. I really feel like the spirit of the season will overtake me when I am turning into one of these classic Christmas movies, and I will be steeping into nostalgia. After the movie, I started making an Indian dessert called rasmalai. Rasmalai is basically a creamy and milky syrup that consists of cottage cheese balls, also called as rasgullas. The super soft cottage cheese in this recipe is the essence of the recipe and makes it a great dessert for a special occasion, and it's always served chilled. After the sunset, we decided to go for a night drive, which is mainly in our neighborhood, and also we have went to see a Taki light. As Aristotle said, it is during our darkest moments that we must focus to see the light. As you start and end your day, be thankful for every little thing in your life. You will come to realize how blessed you really are. . 2020 was a very different year for every one of us. It has taught many lessons. The most important lesson is the world can change so quickly. We will hope for a better 2021, a year of unlimited possibilities, an abundance of real love, health, wealth, and success. We wish you a happy new year. If you like our video, please subscribe to our channel and give us a thumbs up. We'll see you in the next vlog. Thank you for watching.